Welcome to Championship Wrestling at Ringside. This is Vince McMahon along with Mean Gene Okerlund. On hand this week, no less than Tito Santana to square off against Tiger Chung Lee. We'll also have with us Superfly Jimmy Snuka. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, making his very first appearance here, Bulldog Buzz Sawyer, squaring off against Special Delivery Jones, but that's not the half of it.
Well, the big one coming up, of course, the fact Adrian Adonis, Dick Murdoch to challenge Rocky Johnson, Tony Atlas, right here for the World Tag Team Championship, and in Piper's Pit, promised by Captain Lou Albano, an appearance by singing great Cyndi Lauper. I'll have to see that.
No doubt. We'll all look forward for Cyndi Lauper to join us, along with the tag team title matchup. We'll be back as we continue in just a moment.
Ali, Special Delivery Jones. From St. Petersburg, Florida, weighing in at 260 pounds, it is Bulldog Buzz Sawyer and his manager, Captain Lou Albano.
Well, sir, Ray, counted as one of the most aggressive wrestlers you'll ever see. Bulldog Buzz through the ropes. Here he goes after SP Jones.
The roads will lead in the state of New Jersey this Monday night, the 28th of May, to Wayne, to the beautiful William Patterson College Recreation Center in Wayne, New Jersey. Good seats are still on sale at the box office. It is going to be a tremendous spectacular. From Tito Santana to the Wild Samoans, from Rocky Johnson to Superfly Jimmy Snuka, it all shapes up as a big card at the Patterson Recreation College Center in Wayne, New Jersey this Monday night.
Buzz Sawyer all over Special Delivery Jones.
That one particular move, I must say, I was impressed. Sawyer in the neighborhood of 260 pounds under the tutelage of Lou Albano, and he really appears to be off the wall and certainly aggressive, to say the least.
The Bulldog with SD now. Special delivery. Oh, my, look at that, right on his head.
One.
I think I actually heard him growling in there moments ago. SD firing off a left hand. Double shot there. Look at this now. SD asserting himself. Forearm knocks SD down, however.
What a physique. On both. Oh, he's fighting him. Bulldog Buzz Sawyer biting the side of S.D. Jones.
And semblance of a bear hug there, yes.
Look at.
Yes, you can
see the bite mark.
S.D. trying now to, in some way, to escape or counter the hold. Headbutt by S.D.
That may do it.
Look at that. Look at Sawyer get himself right back up. Headbutt again by SD. Look at Sawyer breaking the face.
Come
Sawyer
on.
Using a top rope to his advantage.
Well, I have not seen a lot of scientific wrestling. Knowledge exhibited on the part of Bulldog Buzz Sawyer. As a matter of fact, he's really a street brawler.
SD landing on his feet. And look.
What is this?
You know, he even looks like a bulldog.
Two, three. One, two, three.
Biting one of the fingers, maybe the thumb, of SD Jones. SD was really in pain moments ago.
Look at this. celebration, the arrival of Bulldog, Buzz Sawyer, St. Petersburg, Florida.
Again today,
Bearhawk. Dogs in pain.
Look at that. Look at that. That takes awesome power. Bulldog power.
One, two.
What's that fight like that?
Referee to make sure that indeed there is no more fighting. I'm certain, Vince, that the influence of Captain Lou Albano is going to show on Mr. Sawyer. You really can't argue with success because Albano is of late, the past few years, has enjoyed a great deal of it. High, raked in the look ahead, but yes now, SD, bringing this crowd back up. Bulldog Buzz in trouble. Boy, he is a block of granite, this Bulldog.
Well, he's got to be one of the most...
Headbutt again.
Oh, one of the most durable men I've ever seen.
Off the rope, shoulder block. SD on the rope. Off the rope, again now. Oh, wow, did you see that?
Maneuver.
That was most impressive. Wait a minute. Sawyer.
Come on. He's proved his point. He certainly proved his point.
With That's a very incredible, impressive. This man. Look oh. at, take a look at this man, would you? Let's go back to what we saw moments ago. All right, here we go. Bulldog now. Oh, what a shoulder block. From there, off the rope now. And look at this maneuver.
The sidewinder, absolutely devastating. Bulldog, Buzz Sawyer. Sawyer the man. It gets the three count over SD Super. Or special delivery zones in that particular case. I'm going to confront.
Let's get the official time if we may.
Here we go.
And the winner, Bulldog Buzz Sawyer.
Well, Sawyer victorious in his very first appearance this week in this particular World Wrestling Federation event. And I must say, in all due respect, it was a very impressive win. That sidewinder suplex was absolutely devastating to take a man the size of SD Jones down to the mat in that fashion. You've just got to be impressed with that kind of talent. Very, very interesting feature from my colleague regarding the latest that's happening in the World Wrestling Federation, Vince McMahon, and the World Wrestling Federation update.
This week's update concerns, ladies and gentlemen, the most extraordinary athlete of this or any other generation, and certainly the most extraordinary athlete in professional wrestling history, Andre the Giant. Let's take you now to recent videotape footage of the one and the only Andre making his way to the squared circle.
And there, ladies and gentlemen, with a smile on his face, God also certainly only made one like this, standing 7 feet, 4 inches, weighing, ladies and gentlemen, close to the 500-pound mark, the biggest and indeed the most extraordinary athlete of this or any other generation. There, ladies and gentlemen, the one and the only, Andre the Giant.
The official World Wrestling Federation magazine no doubt follows the footsteps of Andre the Giant in matches, but also follows the one and the only Andre outside the world of pro wrestling, all the way to a restaurant owned by Andre the Giant in Montreal, Le Pliché. And no doubt, Andre the Giant just as much at home with a knife and a fork in his hand in his own restaurant as he is in the squared circle. He is truly one of a kind, Andre the Giant.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is set for one fall, with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Reno, Nevada, weighing in at 252 pounds, here is Lenny Keen. And his opponent from the Fiji Islands, weighing in at 250 pounds, here is Jimmy Superfly Sanuka.
Yes, indeed, the Superfly. Take a look at some of those Superfly hands there. Jimmy Snuka, number one. Yes, indeed. So many fans feel that this extraordinary athlete is indeed number one. One of the all-time great competitors in the World Wrestling Federation today. Would you concur with that, Gene?
I agree totally on that particular point, Vince. And tremendous popularity. Popularity like I've not seen before. A very charismatic individual also. A man who has said time and time again he prefers to do his talking within the confines of the squared circle.
Superfly Snuka, noted, of course, for the actually depth of, take a look at that physique. He's really put together.
Oh, that's incredible.
Known, of course, for the death-defying maneuver, which only Mr. Snuka has been able to do. Only one man in pro wrestling history does what he does. And that's, of course, the Superfly himself. Locking up now with Lenny Keen.
Watch All-Star Wrestling every Saturday morning here on Channel 9 at 10 a.m. All-Star Wrestling, 10 a.m. Saturdays here on WOR-TV. In Berwick, Pennsylvania, 1 week from today, Saturday, June 2nd, at 1:30 p.m., an all-star card will come to the Berwick Area High School gym, featuring, among others, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Then on June 3rd, a Sunday night in Oswego, New York, the action will shift to the State University of New York, Laker Hall, with Ivan Putski on the card.
Looking for his opportunity. Locking back up now with Lanny Keen. Keen trying to assert himself. Snuka quickly going to the standing side headlock.
You know, Snuka really has the propensity of being able to
did you see that?
Capitalize an opportunity as we just saw.
Snuka now with Keen, snaps him over with authority. Superfly now, back to the standing position.
Opponent, Lanny Keen at 252 pounds right now, feeling the wrath of the very popular Superfly. Keen from Reno, Nevada, beautiful city, a lot of action. Up on the California border.
Lanny Keen hoping for a different kind of action right now and sets him up for the back, no! Up goes Keen! Back to the canvas, and the Superfly maintains control. Keen thought he had the back body drop ball set up to perfection.
Oh, one arm snap.
Yes. Snuka went right over him.
Well, Jimmy Superfly Snuka certainly a tremendous competitor and a man at is just a total wrestling machine, a total package. He's got all the physical credentials and tremendous scientific, I'd even say instinctive, wrestling knowledge and ability.
Let's go back, take a look at what we saw just moments ago. Here now, into the rope. Goes to show you just the instinct you made reference to earlier. Back body drop it, look at that. Cleared him so easily. Back to live action. And Snuka now, wrenching the neck of Lanny Keen. It takes split-second timing to do what Mr. Snuka does.
Now, he's got such a tremendous feel for the sport, Vince. He is so fluid. It just happens, and I've got to use that term. I don't want to run it in the ground, but instinctively, a man reacts.
Off the rope, Snuka now, over Lanny Keene from the far side. Coming back now, puts on the brakes. Grabbed the arm, snapped him right over. Keene disoriented moments ago. Thus far, Lanny Keene has been somewhat outclassed.
Well, that may be kind on your part, Vince. He is not minding any kind of defensive at all against the Superfly in this particular World Wrestling Federation one-on-one confrontation.
And Lanny Keene, who is not having a good time in there based upon his vocal effort.
All right, referee, as you can hear, checking with Keene on a possibility of a submission. And that's the job of the referee. I think that should be pointed out.
Lanny Keene now being set up. Snuka, does he get him? Yes. Nice back body drop. Snuka with a handful of hair assists Mr. Keene. Oh, all the way up off his feet. Snuka drives the knee to the head. That'll keep him down there for a while. And Snuka going up.
Crowd on it.
Superfly Snuka on the top rope.
Superfly headbutt.
Oh! You may count to three or 300. The party is over.
Is that a sight to see?
Here is the winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Yes, indeed. One of the most phenomenal athletes, I guess, the World Wrestling Federation has ever seen. Let's go back now. Take a look at what we saw here. Snuka going up to the top rope. Lanny Keene had been summarily knocked, I would suspect, really unconscious as Snuka drove the knee into the head. And then from there, well, it's just all the Superfly coming down at the speed of gravity as we see the impact of the leap of Superfly Snuka and the devastating maneuver that only the Superfly can put on Lanny Keene. Let's take a look now at an address for the benefit of those who'd like to drop us a line. Maybe you want to write Mr. Snuka a note. We welcome your notes and comments every week. WWF Headquarters, P.O. Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836.
Fans of the Big Apple, New York City, and the greater metropolitan area, Madison Square Garden, Saturday night, June 16th. Talk about your bombshells. This is it. In a return bout, the Iron Sheik will be doing battle with this man. No stranger, of course, the fans here, Sergeant Slaughter, and they're calling it, and it has been sanctioned, a boot camp match. We need an explanation. What is a boot camp match?
Well, you know, a few weeks ago, I came out here and I showed the people what this steel boot would do to a chair. What I wanted to do to your head, Iron Sheik. But they protested. They took the boot away from me. Then they attacked my protege, Terry Daniels. Gave him a nice groin shot. Well, let me tell you, Iron Sheik, I went to the promoters. I begged them, please, just give me one more match, and that'll be it. And I said, I want a boot camp match. That's where two men go behind the barracks, and the best man walks out. Now, a boot camp match goes like this. There are no rules, so I can wear my combat boots with the steel toes, and I can run it into your head,
hey.
Iron Sheik. I can run that into your head. I will be able to this time. There won't be a referee in the ring. He's stationed outside the ring. And the only time he comes in is when your body is laying there prone and I lay on top of it for a 1, 2, 3. Or you're gasping for your last breath in the Cobra Clutch. Falls can count on the floor. They can count in the locker room. It doesn't matter. You're all mine, Sheik. All mine. All mine.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I cannot believe Sergeant Slaughter in a boot camp match against the Iron Sheik. Tito Santana.
I'm a little shaky. You're going to have to excuse my state of mind, but the man is really intent on getting the Sheik once and for all. Tito Santana, Intercontinental Champion, June 16th, and of course, Saturday night, Madison Square Garden, Greg the Hammer Valentine to challenge you.
That's right, Gene. You know, the competition just keeps coming after this belt, but it's still around my waist, Gene. Greg the Hammer Valentine came in to the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, and he says, I come in for one purpose, and that's for some title matches. He claims that he's going to win both title titles, the world belt and the intercontinental belt. Well, your chances coming up against Tito Santana, Greg Valentine. You and your hammer and your figure four leg lock. I've seen you break the rules, and I've seen you hurt a lot of wrestlers with that figure four leg lock. You're good, but you're better when you got your man down. But Tito Santana is going to be ready for you right here in the Big Apple. I guarantee you. Arriba!
Intercontinental Champion Tito Santana to be challenged by Greg the Hammer Valentine, Iron Sheik, Freddie Blassie. You dodged the bullet once, but I don't believe you're going to be able to do it for a second time.
Well, Sergeant Slaughter doesn't think for one second that we're going to stand by idle while he's coming in with these leaded boots. And furthermore, that's in our favor with the referee on the outside the ring. We can do anything we want. And as far as that other geek that was standing there holding that flag, while the Sheik and I were watching Slaughter in the ring over there wrestling, this guy was back there mumbling and cursing the Iron Sheik under his breath. And then when the Sheik walked over to him like a gentleman and asked him, what are you saying, sonny boy? He spit at the Sheik. And that's the reason why the Sheik attacked him.
Sheik Lahani, Iron Sheik, I see a look of concern, quite obviously, on your face at this point in time.
I'm glad my manager is an American, honest man. He explained for all American what was the situation. Now, Soldier Slaughter, you coming over, cry about it. You can't take it anymore. Or might as well stay South Carolina and stay in the Marine South Carolina instead of you come to the Big Apple, Madison Square Garden, wrestling with the World Heavyweight Champion, wrestling with the Iron Sheik, the Olympic Champion, AAU Champion, Pan American Champion, Iranian Champion. Ayatollah Blasi told me, Sheik,
Hallelujah.
This time don't worry about nothing. This is our sport. This is our game. And I'm going to do something to you. Swear to Ayatollah Khomeini. Nobody going to recognize that ugly face, especially your family, you American hug.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Madison Square Garden, Saturday night, June the 16th.
In the next contest, there's a one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, in the corner to my left, from Korea, weighing 270 pounds, here is Tiger Chung Lee. And his opponent, the corner to my right, from Tosculo, Mexico, weighing 235 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Tito Santana.
Vince, you may notice on the back of that beautiful jacket being worn by Tito Santana, it is a RRIVA. And of course, in Spanish, the V pronounced with a B, and hence Arriba.
To the rope now, Tiger Chung Lee, and this is going to be an exciting matchup. Mr. Lee, having perhaps skills that Mr. Santana does not have, and vice versa. Very even matchup here.
Upcoming World Wrestling Federation action this Friday night, June 1st, Poughkeepsie, New York, the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. Ivan Putski coming to town on Wednesday, June 6th, in Old Westbury, Long Island, at the State University of New York at Old Westbury. Superfly Snuka tops the card. Thursday, June 7th, Nanticoke, Pennsylvania, the Nanticoke Area High School Gym. Greg the Hammer Valentine in action. And on Friday, June 8th, in Milford, Pennsylvania, at the Delaware Valley High School Gym, you'll see Rocky Johnson and Ivan Putski team up.
Tiger Chung Lee missing with the elbow. Big takedown, Tito Santana. Really going at it with Tiger Chung Lee. Arm drag takedown again. Santana a little bit quicker than Lee.
Well, that was clearly demonstrated as Santana was able to really scurry around and put a couple of consecutive moves on Tiger Chung Lee that right now have him at an obvious disadvantage. Working that arm on the left side. Tiger Chung Lee. Lee in the neighborhood of maybe 25, 28 pounds heavier than Tito Santana.
In control of things at the moment, Tito Santana. And we haven't seen a great deal of the martial art yet on the part of Tiger Chung Lee, who certainly most capable of using the martial art tactics. Nice reversal by Santana off the rope now, trying to set him up, does indeed. Nice butt body drop. On his feet, not for long. Santana hooking the arm and takes over Tiger Chung Lee. Nice arm drag takedown.
No!
Grunts and groans of both Santana and Tiger Chung Lee. Lee now trying to set Santana up, sets him up in the back. No, leapfrog by Santana, drop kick by Santana. Arm drag takedown again. And Santana rushes into his opponent, pulls him right over. If he misses with an arm drag takedown, however, he's going to be in trouble.
But I'll tell you, you just saw it. Two perfectly timed moves on the part of the Intercontinental Champions. First, the jump over. And the fly drop kick followed by the arm drag takedown. And at this point in time, Tiger Chung Lee is quite obvious by the expression on his face and a great deal of pain.
And now Lee shoving Santana to the rope, arm drag. Oh,
nice shoulder.
Back body drop attempt earlier, but now you see the knee. I think it was in the shoulder, actually the knee striking the shoulder, perhaps the foot striking the lower abdominal area.
I think that was a good choice of words. Now, Tiger Chung Lee exhibiting some of his martial arts skills that Vince McMahon had alluded to earlier. And Santana here on a receiving end of a knee to the head. It's Santana to the canvas. Tiger Chung Lee. And boy, has the momentum turned around here. It is one-on-one confrontation.
Kick to the head. Santana having his problems, as well you might suspect now. Oh, sort of a lunge and an awful lot behind it, but back, Mr. Lee off. Moment.
Right to the face.
That is not going to help the rather handsome features of Mr. Santana, any. Again.
I don't know if there's a communications problem between the referee and Tiger Chung Lee, but apparently the first reprimand of...
Well, now off the second rope, and that'll definitely take its toll. Karate chop across the back of the neck. 2-1.
Wow. Wow, was that close.
This, a non-title matchup, nonetheless, I'm sure it means almost as much, if not if as much, to Mr. Santana, as well as to Lee. This is going to be bad for... Oh, forget about it. Yes, indeed, a victory for Tiger.
How does he do it?
That's amazing. Tiger Chung Lee. Well, the chop to the throat, and Santana. Look at Lee now. Lee. Oh, and a back kick. Down he goes. Devastating maneuver by Tiger Chung Lee. Here, the weight advantage. The more aggressive style of Tiger Chung Lee coming in to play. Listen to this capacity clap.
Indeed.
Yes, indeed. lead. Latin Lightning striking just moments ago. Tito Santana with what really, I guess, was an upset considering the way that the match had progressed.
And here is the winner, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Tito Santana.
Tito Santana, victorious. Let's go back now to what we saw just moments ago. And Tiger Chung Lee was just eating Santana up alive here. However, Santana had almost a desperation attempt, lunging and hammering with that beautiful forearm right into the head of Tiger Chung Lee, stunning him, and Tito Santana on to victory. Santana is something else.
Now you tell me that RP can't be cool. You're looking at the hostess with the mostest right here. You're looking at tuna fish with good taste, the cream in your coffee, but not the coup de grace. The coup de grace is, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to give a welcome to the one and only, the star of today, Miss Cyndi Lauper, managed by the great Lou Albino. Come on out. Lou, it's nice to see you. And Miss Cyndi Lauper. I miss Cyndi Lauper. Just a second, Cyndi Lauper.
Oh, she's coming right over.
She's a little delayed, Roddy. She'll be short away.
What do you mean she's a little delayed? What do you mean she's a little delayed?
I believe the plane was a little late. She's on the way. Just hold a second. She's on the way. She'll be here.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
The plane was held up a little bit. Just a little bit delayed. She's on the way. She's coming.
What are you talking about? Is Cyndi Lauper here or is Cyndi Lauper here? What do you mean, man? She ain't under no couch.
She's coming, Roddy.
What are you doing, man? What are you talking about, man? What are you talking about? I dressed up like this. Where's Cyndi Lauper?
Yeah.
I'm sure you must have told
her. Yeah, I told her to be here and they were delayed. The plane was held back, but she's on her way. She's coming.
Did you tell her to be
that
here?
That Dave Wolf, I'll bet you that Dave Dog is the one that told her not to come.
You're a man of your word. I believe you. If Dave Wolf, there's some guy around here, his name is Dave Wolf, who's going around pulling strings, doing all kinds of things. I'll tell you what. Nobody makes a fool. I come out here trying to be a gentleman, trying to be, I'm sick and tired of it. I'll tell you what I'll do. Nobody makes a fool of me. I'll tell you, Dave Wolf, nobody cries wolf on Roddy Piper. I will have Dave Wolf here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is a title match for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Introducing in the corner to my left, the challenger from New York City, weighing 252 pounds, it is Adrian Adonis. And his partner from Waukehachie, weighing 275 pounds, it is Dick Murdoch. And the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing in at 250 pounds, it is Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. And his partner from Washington, D.C., weighing 240 pounds, it is Rocky Johnson.
Yes, indeed, Atlas and Johnson and their tag team title defense, and this is going to be an extraordinary matchup. Adrian Adonis, Dick Murdoch, I think you would concur, Gene Okerlund, two of the toughest contenders in professional wrestling today.
Well, at this point in time, they've got to be considered the number one contending tag team of the World Wrestling Federation, and boy, can they play this game rough and tough.
All right, here we go.
Saturday Night Fever grips the Big Apple when the World Wrestling Federation returns anew to Madison Square Garden on Saturday night, June 16th at 8 p.m. Get those advance tickets at the Garden box office and all Ticketron locations. A tremendous card is being assembled with two big bouts certainly topping the bill. Andre the Giant meeting Dr. D, David Schultz, and Showdown. Sergeant Slaughter, the Iron Sheik, a boot camp match in Madison Square Garden, June 16th.
Rocky in control. Adrian Adonis off the rope. No, sir. Look at Adrian. Off the rope now, waiting for him. Yes, indeed. Rocky Johnson has climbed out of the canvas.
Oh, no.
Oh, Atlas lets him have it. Rocky takes him over. Dick Murdoch. Certainly not above bending the rules a bit or out and out breaking them if he thinks he can get away with it.
Well, thus far it has been all Johnson. He is totally dominated, even at one point in time, both Murdoch and Adonis.
Of course, that not a long-lasting situation. Now, slammed to the canvas. Nicely done by Adonis, favoring his arm a bit. Tag is made. Now, Dick Murdoch goes down to the canvas. Tag is made. Atlas now comes in. With the arm bar on Big Dick Murdoch.
You talk about somebody capable of really tightening the screws. You've got to say that.
How about that?
USA.
Yes. How about the nip up, though, by Dick Murdoch showing his agility?
I'm impressed for a man, especially the size of Murdoch.
Really applying the pressure here, and if any one man can make you feel like you're going to be minus an arm, it would be Atlas.
Well, he's just throwing Murdoch around like a light sack of potatoes, I might add.
Atlas back to the corner, and Dick Murdoch. Oh my goodness, Atlas trying to retaliate. Murdoch, no, nice reversal. Oh, but Atlas ran right into the elbow, and another one. No, that's not going to help at all. Downstairs goes Adonis. Elbow. Having a way on Atlas. They are really going to work on Tony Atlas.
Oh, the world. It is funny that at this point in time, Atlas hasn't folded with the punishment.
Down. After the double elbow, and Adonis must vacate the premises. A right hand. Dick Murdoch going toe-to-toe. Headbutt by Atlas.
I believe Murdoch was airborne momentarily as a result of that headbutt.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Atlas now dazed and not knowing where he was a moment ago, reaching for the tag for Rocky, and he was in the wrong corner. A cover! No. Easy kick out by Atlas. Adonis now tagging in. Ooh. Headbutt by Atlas and Adonis hurt. Here comes Rocky. Drop kick. Rocky on the warpath. Murdoch in there.
He is a virtual one-man game.
All four wrestlers in the ring. A real Donnybrook, Adonis, Murdoch into each other. Oh. All right, Boston Crab, we have... No, oh, my. Oh, my.
Totally illegal.
Headbutt. Adonis, Murdoch, outside, hammering away. Oh, no. Look at this. Oh, my. From behind. Rocky hooked by Adonis, gets three.
Oh, no. I can't believe that.
I can't believe that either.
You have got to be kidding me.
Rocky really
herself, but there you see a tag team. Adonis and Murdoch, I believe, have pulled this off.
I am in shock.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it are the winners and the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch.
Adonis and Murdoch, it's official. In this capacity, crowd does not like it at all. Let's go back, Gene. Take a look at what we saw just moments ago.
Well, total chaos. You can see all four men involved, both in and out. Being the capitalist that he is, Adrian Adonis comes up with the victory roll on Rocky Johnson. And my word, just that quick, we've got brand new World Tag Team Champions.
Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch, the newly crowned tag team title holder.
The great fans over in the Garden State, Wayne, New Jersey, get ready. William Patterson College Recreational Center, this coming Monday night with an 8 o'clock start, the World Wrestling Federation is coming to town. We talk about the World Wrestling Federation. We talk about the talent of the Wild Samoans, Rocky Johnson and Tony Atlas, and, of course, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and also Greg the Hammer Valentine, certainly rising to the top in a big hurry back here in the World Wrestling Federation.
The only reason I am back is to become a champion, is to become the world champion, to become the intercontinental champion. If I could find a partner, I want to be one half of the world tag team champion.
That's awfully
I want
ambitious
them all.
Thinking.
Well, I'm an ambitious man, and I thrive on competition. You named all the greats in the WWF, but you didn't mention Greg the Hammer Valentine. Number one professional wrestler in the WWF, as far as I'm concerned, and it's not self-proclaimed either. I have proven what I can do in the past. You have seen wrestlers go up against me, and they've been carried out on stretchers with my figure four leg lock. Any wrestler, professional wrestler that goes against Greg Valentine, whether he wins or loses the match against me, he's got to think in the back of his mind, will this be the night, will this be the day, whatever, that the man gets the figure four leg lock. I mean, maybe it could end my career.
Name a man for life could permanently damage a man. I mean,
well, he's broken many a leg.
There's not only broken a leg, has actually had dislocated from the hip. The amount of pressure applied per cubic inch, 91.3 pounds per cubic inch, can sever a man's leg. I mean, the tibia, the fibia, go right back to the lower lumbar of the back. I mean, it's devastating. I find it hard to believe. I wouldn't want it.
All right, fans, you're going to be seeing him in action in New Jersey coming up.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Kansas City, weighing 248 pounds, here is Cowboy Bob Orton. And his opponent in the corner to my right, from Lexington, Kentucky, weighing 229 pounds, it is Billy Travis.
Billy Travis to meet Cowboy Bob Orton.
A happy face.
Yes, indeed. There are many happy faces here this week, and why not? We have seen all kinds of happenings, which we will comment on momentarily. Cowboy Bob Orton and Mr. Travis goes high in the air down to the canvas. Off the rope, Bob Orton hammering away on Billy Travis. And what about that tag team title match earlier on?
What a bombshell. I'm still in somewhat of shock.
I don't know if you can really call it an upset or not, but nonetheless, the fact remains there are brand new tag team champions in the form of Dick Murdoch and Adrian Adonis, the Wrecking Crew.
By Travis, shot way, way high in the air by Cowboy Bob Orton. And that is a Wrecking Crew, that combination of Adonis and Murdoch. However, I would suspect that Adonis and Murdoch are going to fall on hard times, I would think. You can bet Atlas and Johnson will continue teaming and continue to challenge the current champions. Although I'm sure there'll be other challengers, many of them.
Well, the only thing, as Bob Orton body slams Billy Travis, I should point out, it puts Adonis and Murdoch in a position where they now can operate more defensively than offensively.
Very true. Good point. How embarrassed do you think Lou Albano was that Cyndi Lauper didn't show up this week?
I don't know. I think Rowdy Roddy Piper was somewhat taken back by it all.
I think Lou Albano, I've never seen, he was so upset, it was incredible. Allegedly, and we say allegedly, according to Lou Albano, Miss Lauper was late or had some sort of transportation difficulty or whatever the case may
be. Apparently there was a plane that was running late.
Then again, Albano claimed that this fellow David Wolf had something. Is he the manager or is Lou Albano the manager of Cyndi Lauper?
Well, Albano contends that yes, he indeed is the manager, but in light of what happened this week, I might question it.
Look at this now. Only one man makes this superplex move. Covering Travis and Cowboy Bob Orton is victorious.
Oh.
Another cowboy there. Hopefully no relation to Mr. Orton. Looked like his great grandfather.
Here is the winner, Cowboy Bob Orton.
Earlier on, we saw Bulldog Buzz Sawyer make quite an auspicious debut. And of course, Superfly Snuka continues to fly. Tito Santana victorious in a surprise, really indeed. And of course, the tag team champions newly crowned, Adonis and Murdoch. And just moments ago, Cowboy Bob Orton victorious. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, to join us, we will look forward to Rowdy Roddy Piper and his guest next week. We'll get to the bottom of that situation. David Wolf will be here, along with Sergeant Slaughter, Chief J. Strongbow against Greg Valentine, and a whole lot more.